Welcome back from that short commercial break. You're still watching Saloon Talk with your girl Shabara. He is right here at Spectra Saloon in Bukolobi. Like I said earlier before, they have three branches, one in Kabalagala, one in Machindia, and then one in Bukolobi. Come down, grab yourself a package. These guys have amazing care and you will not be disappointed. Before we went for the commercial break, we were actually getting to know our guests, getting to know a little about them. And of course, Joshua Baraka in the building. Very many of you are asking us, oh, what are you bringing, Joshua? He's now here. Are you satisfied? Of course, you'll always be satisfied when it comes to Saloon Talk. Our topic for today is dating and professions. Would you be picking a partner or choosing a partner if it comes to their professions? What do you have to say about that? Don't forget to go down to our social media platforms on that is Urban Television Uganda, sorry. And of course, leave there a comment or a question that you want us to ask. I guess we shall be getting it right here on the show. So guys, I already got to know about your relationship status, and you told me you're dating, and you told me you're single. Me, mine is complicated, but that is a different issue. But then, now I want to know the question at hand at first. Would you be picky when it comes to choosing a partner depending on their profession? I'm going to start with
you. No, I think I wouldn't be picky.
What do you consider when you're choosing someone? You consider money?
Yeah. I'm being frank.
What?
Yeah.
If I thought you're going to be like,
No. As long as the person has money, good characters, period.
So if he has money but he has a figure P,
That doesn't matter.
An upside
as
P.
That doesn't matter. Yeah. To me, that doesn't matter.
Yeah. You are this people they call gold diggers. Because that's
literally I'm a gold digger. No, I'm not a gold digger. Uh-huh. But the point is, like in life, we all want money. And we are happy where money is.
Yeah.
I don't believe in these beliefs which says that with love, you can be happy. Oh, okay. Yeah, because God loved us without money, whatever we had. But he still loved us. But me, I would prefer someone who has money.
I'm seeing people as if the world was about to end, you wouldn't survive.
No, survive.
No technology, no nothing, no money.
No. Survive, yeah. No, I'm being frank. Like,
yeah.
Imagine dating someone who has no money and maybe this person starts cheating. You would bear with someone who has money, though they cheat. I don't care.
What?
For real?
This is juicy Baraka gossip. Joshua.
I want to ask you a question. Okay. I have two questions. The first one, wouldn't care for their career? Like, no matter what they are doing? Like, even if they are making the money through, like shaky stuff.
Serial killer type of
and then also question number two, what's your love language?
This man asked my questions.
Let me start with the last question. Yeah. My love language is money. And the other question you've asked me, as long as it has nothing to do with people dying, it's okay. Let him bring that money.
So, but he can still be a mufere. Because there's no one who's dying.
That person, Aja Genda Fele, a letter sent. You know that
can affect you at some point.
Wait, how?
Like, you could be considered his accomplice.
Hmm. My dear, I've said, you know, Ufela, bring that money, we invest somewhere. And in case someone comes in and says, Muliba Ziba Misanga, I'll be like, we're getting money from this business. That Ufela.
Because you see paper, there's always a trace when it comes to paper. Serial numbers and all that, just like a gun. You can always trace where the gun was bought from or who owned the gun. So when it comes to paper, if I told you you're trying to invest it in something, there is always a paper trail. So that paper trail will come, and like exactly as she said, when they take him in, you're going to be an accomplice. And being an accomplice,
but remember,
that is
Sovaria,
also time served.
Sovaria, remember, we have money. We can do anything to bring him out.
Yeah, so you just do the bad black effect. You go to prison, enjoy your time.
Baraka, your question.
Would you be with someone you don't love because they have money?
Yeah, she's basically saying money.
I think I would bear with someone who has money than bearing with someone who loves me and they don't have money. My dear, we're not going to eat love.
Okay. Let me ask you something. You just care only about the money. You don't care where he's getting it from. But don't you care that his source of money should be stable in that you're not going to be with him and 5 years down the line he loses all the money? What then?
And there's no cash. Oba, you leave, you walk away.
I've told you, he will bring this money. Oba zibye, oba zijewa. We shall invest in some other business that is going to bring money tomorrow.
There's a random guy out there who's watching the show. Who's like, she's my type of woman. When can I get her? Yo, Joshua, the same so question goes to you. Would you be picky when it comes to choosing a partner?
Kind of, but not really. But
how?
Kind of. I would want someone who has something going for themselves, like, you know, who's bringing, like, who's also doing something with their lives. You dig? I'm not your main source of income.
Your bank.
Yeah. Okay, and also, I want someone who has a dream, someone who has a vision, someone who's trying to be something, who's trying to build something. You dig? Eh? Not just, you know, just chilling. Yeah.
You talked about love language. You see, I'm always asking this question, and my producer is always telling me, "Anyway, you're always asking people about love language, because people don't actually know what the meaning of what the word love language actually means."
Yeah, and I asked you that because, like, I'm so matched up, but I understand because I feel like in all relationships, there's a point at which, you exhaust everything you can do without money, and now money has to enter. You get, but it doesn't have to be a lot of money. Anyways, love languages are important. It's important to know what your love language is, because sometimes I want to say sometimes you can think you want money, and they give you money, but it's not your love language. Maybe your love language is physical touch or quality time. So it's giving you money, but it's not spending time with you. that means it's not like a serious relationship.
Jesus
you're
Christ!
Cheating.
No.
Yeah.
You're basically answering.
Then basically, he's just your bank. Then you go look for whatever you want elsewhere. So you're cheating. You have like 3 men. Brass, not cow.
But guys, let us get this straight.
Yeah.
You have talked about if he like you can go and get someone else to touch you, but then that person does not have money. So isn't that hypocritical, the fact that you can date someone who has money, but when he's not good enough when it comes to bed, you're gonna go to a broke guy who's gonna give you the best feeling when it comes to those things?
Because then you're hustling the guy.
I say my love language is money. Where would I go for money? Good sex?
And what if he's
money? Good what?
So for you, what turns you on?
As long as
money?
My man can give, like, we can give birth, he has no problem, then why would
I cheat? Giving birth comes with, you know.
He's giving you quality time.
For example, it's always out. Also, the fact that he has money won't mean that he will be a good family person. It doesn't mean he'll be a good father.
What are you talking about? Money is there. I will take my kids where I want them to be. I will do what my kids want them to have.
And what if he has money, but he's a hajj?
So very money.
So you're free with sharing your man just because
it's okay,
he has money?
Because I will get my kids what they want. I will get myself what I want.
There is
I will
a friend
ride
of mine.
I want.
There is a friend of mine. Right now, I'm very sure his legs are in the sky. He's like,
she's
I want that girl.
Exactly.
Because only Joshua, Joshua, you were still telling us about your love language, because I want us to go into those things that people, you know, like they put aside when it comes to choosing someone, and they regard other people.
My love language personally is quality time and also physical touch. Personally, that's just me. I know people say physical touch is for Kampala boys, but yeah, for me it's really quality time and physical touch. But I get, man, I'm so fascinated. I see where you're coming from, and I get that, and I agree with you to like a certain extent. Mm-hmm. But I would also see how that would be a problem, because now a guy is going to come with money, mix you, and dip. And another guy with money will come again, mix you, and dip.
Yeah.
So by like that time, 5 years pass.
You'll be a well without water.
They've mixed you, you have your backing bag, you've gone to Dubai, but no investments, no nothing. You get what I mean? Because let me tell you, a lot of people who make money in illicit ways don't invest it. You get? But anyways, even if you invest, it's okay. But me, personally, I'm on your side. I'm so mashed up.
Thank you, thank you. You talked about of.
I think you always want what you don't have. Yeah. So if right now what you want is money, and then you get it, you're going to want something else.
Yes, yeah,
you're going
true.
To start but noticing he doesn't do this, he doesn't do that.
Let me cut you short. It's not that I have grown up from a poor background or something. No. But like me prioritizing money or saying that love money is my love language, I have reasons as to why. Because yes, maybe I never grew up with my dad, but my mom had money to take care of us. So if I have money, I can also do what my mom did. So I will always say I need money. Money is my love language and I won't go by that. I will always say money is my love language. Thank you.
I love a girl who can stand by her principles. You know, everybody likes something, everybody needs something, everybody craves for something. What I want may not be what you want. That is why there is a saying that one man's meat is another man's poison. Yeah. What I find attractive, you may not find attractive.
So Vera, there is even a saying which says that you better cry in a mansion than crying in a grass thatched house.
Oh,
so me,
wow.
I better cry in a mansion.
You see, as we move on to the next question, I feel like these are stereotypes. You see, because of the world that we live in, these are stereotypes. To me, I believe you can have it all. It's just how have you planned it. You can have everything. You can have a career, you can have a family, you can have the money, you can have the peace, you can have the quiet. It's just how exactly have you attained those things. If you work hard and start with your career, or you can even, because there are people out there that be like, oh, when you have a baby, when you're young, your life is going to end. And no, it doesn't necessarily need that, because there are people, we have seen people who are actually mothers, but are a big deal in the industry, but they were mothers from even way before they became something important. So I feel like when it comes to the reason why majority of people crave for certain materialistic things is because that's the world we live in. But that doesn't mean that's what you want, because you may want something but you don't need it.
By the way, I don't want you to quote me wrong that maybe me wanting money, I don't want to work.
In general.
No. I love working, by the way. I love working and I love when I get my own money, but still I need more money. So how will I get that more money when I get a rich guy? So
you're the ones that want a private jet with the name Savaria.
For me, I respect your decision. And me personally, I wouldn't want to be with someone and guy, they just want my money, but that's just me. I'd want someone who, you know, I wouldn't want it to be just because I have money. And also, I don't think I would be with someone just because they have money. I would want to be there and Tebanyiza, I wake up next to someone, ga toja uli la usungu.
Joshua, toturimba. Before, let me even first come to you. Let me save my question. Let me first come to you. I want you to tell me what's your genuine type of guy. Like when you're looking for a guy or when you're looking for a partner, that's like, are there certain professions that you cannot be like, I cannot go with that guy? Because let me give an example, doctors. Doctors can, they're always called in late in the hours, like they can always leave abrupt. So what are those professions you can be like, I may like this guy, but this profession,
I think what you've said is very intriguing. I think money is important, but for me, it can't be everything. And back to your question, who's the ideal guy and what profession, if I have reservations on profession, I think for me, I consider values. We have to have the same values, the same goals that are aligned in life. And as for profession, I think I would like to say that profession doesn't matter, but it does, because you have to be practical. For example, personally, a DJ wouldn't be the perfect fit for me, because I am reserved, I don't club much, and so the lifestyle he would want isn't the kind of lifestyle I'd fit in. But a corporate guy would work out just fine for me, because I like stability.
Or maybe on that note, it's because of a DJ Benzino. I take corporate guy, yes, what them wins, and I talk to German, you won't find out.
I think.
But you rarely, because those guys are always they always make sure they meet in those booths. Sweetheart, have you, I don't think you've ever gone on a date with a corporate guy. I used to already some restaurant you've never heard about, but it's like very beautiful. You reach the corner, nobody knows you, all the waiters know who he is.
You know, I think that
a personal experience.
I think that when I first meet a person, the first thing I get to know about them is probably not their profession. But then I have to consider a profession at a certain point, because it may come in the way of the relationship. If someone is a DJ and I'm not of that lifestyle,
you won't be comfortable with it.
Yes. And if someone is maybe a doctor and they never have time for the relationship, then definitely, however much you want to maintain that relationship, it's probably not going to work out.
What of these professions that force people or your partner to like go abroad for like a long time? Let me give an example of like they go for 3 months and they're working on projects, or they're doing international relations out there. Does such a job affect you, or you would not mind the space, like the distance between you, if at all there is a mutual understanding?
I think that all comes down to trust. If you trust the person and how much commitment you have to making it work over that distance. But I think right now that would be fine. But if I had a family, then that's when it would be a problem, because the person is never around, and what I signed up for is to have a family in one place.
Yeah. And also, when you guys, this is now a question to all of you. When you're, because people always say looks don't matter, but I feel like that is just bull BS, because it actually does matter. Because yes, I may want a specific character, I may want a specific trait in a person, but by the time I approach you, there is something about your physical body that has pulled me to you. But do you guys think physical attraction does play a big role, or this is just something people just use as an excuse?
First, I want to agree with
Joshua, first take off your shades. People need to see your eyes.
What
you know,
have a hangover?
There is no hangover, even though you have those bedroom eyes, you know, so they need to see them.
Anyways, so first and foremost, I agree with you. Like, you need someone who fits your schedule. Now, for me, my schedule, some days I'm sleeping during day. Then some days, like, I need someone who understands my lifestyle, you get? So, of course, their profession has to fit into what I'm doing. So I'd probably get someone who's also kind of into the nightlife economy, or like
similar to someone.
She's coming home, me I'm leaving home.
Gamba, just go to the stage. You see, there's a girl who has come to dance with you.
You need someone now who understands you, you know, and the professions have to kind of fit.
Align, yeah.
Yeah, and then what was your question?
The part of the fact that if physical traits actually do give up like a big role when it comes to choosing someone.
Yeah, man. Like, I feel like everyone has different things they like, right? I know some guys, if you don't have nice elbows, so everyone has a different thing they like. Yeah. So
what's yours? What's your specific type? Because I'm very sure you're gonna be describing to us your girlfriend. Because if you give us a specific trait, that is the person you're with.
For me, first and foremost, it's not looks. For me, it's not. Although they matter.
But for you, they
it's not what I look at first. For me, I first look at your personality, and if our thinking aligns.
And that's the thing.
Because you can find one very beautiful babe, right, but that's her ideologies are shallow. You can't hold a conversation for 10 minutes. You did.
You see, I want us to get it right.
Yeah.
I want us to get it right. And I want you guys to understand my question very well. How can you tell someone's personality unless you talk to them, right?
And
what pushes you? Because like I said, if I align for five girls there.
Yeah.
If I align five girls, let me say one is putting on normal. Oh, let me just give an example of us since we are here physically.
Yeah.
If you found us, hypothetically speaking, the three of us just standing there.
Yeah.
Who would pick your attention quickly? Yeah. Like your mind would be like,
Yeah.
Let me start with her.
Don't get me wrong, eh? I understand your question. And I acknowledge that beauty is a thing. There are babes that are actually beautiful. Like, you look at and be like, hey, this babe is beautiful. That doesn't mean I'll go talk to her. You dig? Not to be that guy, but for me right now, I've seen a lot of beautiful babes. You dig?
Your babes are Legos, right?
I'm not even, you know, being that guy. But, like, for me to talk to someone, I'm not being pulled by how good they look. Of course, they have to look good, like, to a certain extent,
but not like, so extravagant.
Yeah, it's not like, oh my god, I'm talking to this babe because she's so beautiful. Or like, you get, like, for me, if we talk, I realize I like you when we're talking. Like, before that, I'm talking to you because maybe I need to pass, or like we're somewhere together and I need to talk to you, but not, I'm not talking to you because
so
I find you attractive.
Maybe to understand you before you continue, to understand you very well, you don't look at the physical traits. Yes, you may consider them, but you don't look at them.
Yeah.
So if at all, let me say you had blankets and wine, or you were at a particular event and you wanted to speak to someone.
Yeah.
Obviously, in your case, as Joshua Baraka, you wouldn't go for these clay queens who are all on Snapchat, what, sexy dresses.
Yeah.
You would actually look at the girl who's just seated down, taking her drink, just minding her business.
Yeah, and I would also go for a slay queen if she has the personality I'm looking. Forget what I mean. Like, if we're in a group, and I'm talking, to like a group of, like, let's say babes, I'm talking to them because of certain situations that have pushed me to talk to them, not because I was like, this babe is beautiful, let me go and talk to her. But this is just me. Like, when I'm talking to you, that's when I realize, like, oh, maybe I like this babe. You get, like, I want to look at this babe, and she's so beautiful. I'm like, man, I like this babe. You get what I mean?
Like, the looks,
like,
I'm taking.
Oh my god! Because you're going to find her. Yeah, she doesn't have jazz.
Yeah.
She can't. She's just plain.
She's telling you.
Plain yogurt.
After
no
here.
Flavor.
You know, women these days, by the way, you people are the ones that chase away the men. Yes, we know you want money. They don't front it. You have just met a chick. You have sat down. She has started. By the way, it's in the makeup. You have a day of bag. And you're like,
Savaria, not until he asks for something also.
Of course, when you ask for something,
no,
that's
no,
a
no,
transaction.
I mean
that's
him.
A different. Yeah, I think you're saying
I mean
other
him. No, I mean him.
I agree with Joshua, what he said. I think, for me, the first thing, obviously, when you meet a person, you see how they look, and that may be the first thing that may attract me. But if I talk to someone and then their character isn't matching up to what I like, then I'm going to be turned off. Yeah, so yes,
you'll be like,
and
nah.
And then if someone isn't even as physically as attractive as I thought
as
I wanted in my head, that my ideal guy, if he ends up having a personality that's actually very impressive, I may actually, I may give him more credit than I thought.
May I first be like, okay, there are very many others. I'll find one with the looks, one with the brains, one with the pockets, and one with the character.
Okay.
God will bring him one day.
So, Varia, to get back to your question,
you see money.
Money and character.
Just dollars flying.
And whenever I'm picking a partner, I always find a fireplace, not a firecracker. Just like his.
There is someone who's watching this show at the Rolex stand. Touch the get you, get the chin demo and explain.
When I'm picking a partner, I look for a fireplace, not a firecracker. What do I mean? I said money and character when I was like starting this show, when you asked me. Then to go into details of what I mean by fireplace, not a firecracker. There's someone, just like you said, you see someone, Baraka sees us and be like, oh, I'm going with Savaria because she's brown, she's curvaceous, you know. Me, I wouldn't go for that because when I'm dating, I first give this guy who's vibing me like, maybe like one
some
month,
trial.
One yeah. As I'm trying him, as I'm seeing his money, as I'm seeing his character, until
but as you're enjoying the money,
of course. As I'm like learning to know who is this person.
Yeah.
I don't go by looks because have you ever had anyone who has not been given a job because they look bad? It's about character, what you have like in your brains, because
and the
I've
way
not
you present yourself. Yeah,
exactly. I've not had anyone who they sent him away or they sent her away because he or she looks bad. No, so me, I go with character and money.
Yeah. Character and money.
Yes, I don't go with the looks.
Because you already answered our question. Even if you have a character but no money, that's a no-go.
Yeah, I go for a fireplace. Not a firecracker.
which is something I may have. Or toward the a canoe. Eh? But guys, we are actually coming to the end of the show. We are left with just a few minutes. So we're going to play a quick game, a quad pro game. So I'm gonna be asking a question. You just give me the answer that pops to your head. Yes or no? Just quickly, chap chap. Would you date a person in a mortuary?
Yes.
Would you date a masseuse?
No.
Would you date a boda guy?
No.
You've said you cannot date a masseuse, right? What is the reason as to why?
Man. I don't know. First and foremost, I feel like, okay, it depends. It depends on where she's working. But man, those guys suffer, man. Guy yet you sign them it down the massage and he wants a happy ending. And you see,
and he pays for it. Oh, that's something amazing. So Joshua, as we end the show, give us your upcoming projects, what you have for your fans this year, 2024. Is it gonna be a good year for you? What you have in-
I have a project out called Growing Pains, and on it there's a song called Dalila. Check it out, it's going crazy right now. Do the challenges.
That's all for now. We shall definitely have you back and you give us more update on what Joshua Baraka is up to. Do you have any upcoming projects this year, what you're gonna
I'm
be doing?
I'm looking forward to like ending my university and that's all for now.
And starting professionally to practice.
Exactly.
Okay, do you have any projects coming up?
Well, right now I'm just looking to growing more in my career and developing the skills to do the best I can be.
Yeah, definitely. Guys, we have come to the end of the show. You're watching Saloon Talk right here on Avant TV with your girl Sovara Hills. Feel free to follow me on all my social media platforms. That is Sovara Hills. And also don't forget to follow Urban TV on all the social media platforms. That is Urban Television Uganda. This show runs every single Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. Thank you guys for tuning in. But akatelekeka, quickly, what's your favorite sex position?
Me, I'm a virgin.
You've just told us you're in a relationship. Anyway, guys, see you next week, same time, same place. Don't forget to come and check down Spectra Saloon. Bye. Thank you.